Total knee replacement, probably more than any other procedure that we do, is an operation that really requires a lot of attention to detail. Not only detail on the surgeon's part, but detail on our patient's part in terms of the post-operative follow-up. It's very important, if you're looking to get the best result that you possibly can, to be able to get your knee completely straight and bent as far back as you can get it bent. So to do that, you have to concentrate specifically on those ranges of motion. I see people getting into trouble sometimes when they start walking too much too soon, and then their knee gets swollen and stiff and they can't get their motion. So it's important, again, to get your motion prior to starting any excessive walking. We'll get your knee straight at the time of surgery. It's going to be your job to keep it there. The benefits of rehabilitation are going to pay off in your results, and when all is over, you're going to be happy that you did the things that you need to do to get your results perfect. Now, with the knees and hips, it's important to start your therapy right away, and we generally start with home health care for a couple of weeks and then physical therapy in our office after that. How long do you need to stay in physical therapy? That's a good question. Well, I can usually get a pretty good idea when folks are coming in for their first post-operative visit at about 3 weeks. We see some people who've had a knee replacement and they're walking without a cane or crutch and they're doing just fine at 3 weeks. Maybe those people don't need quite as much therapy as some of the folks that are still using a cane. Why are you still using a cane at 3 or 4 weeks? Well, because maybe you're weak, because you have had arthritis for a long time, your muscles are weak, or you've got some other medical complications or problems which require you to use a cane or a walker for a little bit of additional balance. So most folks need supervised physical therapy for about 4 to 6 weeks after their surgery. Sometimes if the muscles are weak, particularly after hip replacement, they can be weak, you'll need to continue with your exercises almost for the rest of your life. I think that's a very important thing. If you want to keep your knee and your hip strong, need to plan to continue with the exercises.